Hello everyone, I hope you've all had an amazing week and an even better weekend, a relaxing weekend before a lot of us are going back to school on Monday. So I hope it's just been great, and if you've been at home, you've had a good week at home and looking forward to going back to school on Monday. And I've said this about a million times, but I'll be thinking about you and praying about you, for you, all those children who are going back to school, and if you've been at school, for everyone too who's been going to be joining you. So the 8th, Monday, tomorrow is it's International Women's Day, and then on the 14th of March is Mother's Day. So I thought this session can be dedicated to the woman in our lives. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean that they are your mothers. I've got loads of women in my life who have guided me through my life, been there for me through my life, as well as my mum. So one of the verses that I want to share with you is Proverbs 31 verse 25 to 26. It says, "She is strong and is respected by the people. She looks forward to the future with joy. She speaks wise words and teaches others to be kind." So those words, I know, really, really represent my mum. So my mum is respected by loads of people. She always looks forward to the future and what the future will hold, and she's always happy and positive about it. And she speaks wise words and teaches others to be kind. So my mum has really instilled a lot of character that she has taught me over the years of how to treat people, wise words of for my career or for relationships, or there's loads of different things that my mum has taught me over the years, and still is. She doesn't stop now. I can call my mum, even though she's thousands of miles away, I can call my mum with an issue and I say to her, "Mum, I don't know what to do with this. I'm quite confused." And she will give me the best advice that she could do, and it's all filled with love. Whatever she tells me or gives me is all because she loves me, and I think that's really special. Now, unfortunately, some of us aren't as lucky to still have our mum. So my mum's mum isn't here anymore. Some of you don't have mums. Some of you might not have grandmas or grannies, grandmas, and but there always will be a woman figure in your life that will teach you to be wise, teach you to be kind, and really just give you morals to help you through your life. And some of the things that you are taught by these special people, you will carry with you for the rest of your life. So I thought today's activity could be dedicated all to the woman in our life. Now, if you don't have a mum or grandma, that's absolutely fine. You can choose a woman. So at the end of the video, there'll be a picture for you to have a look at. And if you have got the facilities and your parents can, or adults can help you to print the sheet off, you can do that. If you can't print it off, just have a look and create your own one on a piece of paper. Now, it's a flower, and around the flower, it's got different people that do different things for you in your life. And what you're going to do is you're going to think about, so if I were you, I might have two flowers, one specifically just for my mum and one for all the other women in my life, or you can just do one for everyone in your life, so all the women in your life, so mum and everyone else. Because on each petal, you're going to write their name. So around the flower, the first one petal says, "Someone who teaches me." Now, my mum teaches me, not like going to school teaching, but my mum teaches me life lessons. And, or you could write your teacher if she's a lady and she teaches you things during the day. Or it can be someone else that's a lady in your life that teaches you. So you write their name on that petal, and then you decorate that petal and you pray for them. Then someone who feeds me, It might not be mum, it might be auntie, it might be neighbor, it might be whoever, whichever lady feeds you, you write their name in the petal and you decorate that petal. Now, each petal can be a different decoration. You don't have to do the flower all in one color. It can be entirely up to how you want to do it. If you want to do the flower all in one color, that's fine. Then the next one says, someone who encourages me. It might be a friend, a girl that's a friend. It might be a relative, an auntie, a sister, a cousin, anyone that's a female that that encourages you. That's why I said all these things around the flower fit my mum. But then there's also other ladies in my life who do that too, who do certain things in my life too. So that's why you might want to have two, one dedicated just for your mum and one for all the other ladies. But if you don't want to, you can do one and just do all the ladies around them. Someone who asks me how I am. So it might be a friend, again, that's a girl. It might be your mum in the morning. It might be your grandma. It might be your auntie. It might be a neighbor. Just any lady that might say that to you, that makes you really feel that you are cared for. Okay? And then another one would be someone who I can talk to when I am worried. Again, this could be a girl that's a friend, or it could be a teacher that's a lady. It could be a mum, it could be a nanny. It could be loads of people that are ladies that help, you trust to talk to when you are worried. And then someone who makes me laugh. I've got loads of ladies in my life who make me laugh. So friends as well that are the same age as me who are ladies, and they make me really laugh. And my family, there's ladies in my family who do that too. So you can, if you're not sure who to put in the petals, what you can do is pray to God. And when a name pops into your head, you can put that name down, because that's God talking to you about which lady he should put you on your heart when you're thinking about that particular thing that they do for you in your life. And then the last one says, someone who gives good hugs. So I haven't had my mum's good hugs for over a year now, but definitely she gives big bear hugs. And I know there's quite a few people, obviously during coronavirus, we haven't been allowed to give other people hugs except our family in our house. So that's quite difficult to think about, because I might have forgotten what a good hug feels like. But just think back to someone who really gives you a good tight cuddle and you feel safe in their arms, a lady who does that for you. And again, it can be any lady in your life. It doesn't have to be just your mum or your nan or anyone. It can be any lady who you trust and who does, who makes you feel that in your life. And like I said, if you're unsure which person to choose to put in the petal, just pray to God. Just ask him which person he would want to put on your heart. And then you put them in the petal, you decorate the petal, you decorate the rest of the flower, and then that can go on your wall, or it can be given to your mum if you've done one, a whole one for your mum. But put it up on your wall, and then when you see it, say a prayer for them, just thanking God that those, that particular lady. So pray once a day, pray one a day, and then actually say the name. You can do a general prayer with all the ladies, but just say, like, say, so in the morning, I thank God that my mum is there so that I can talk to her when I'm really worried. Or I thank God that my auntie's there to make me laugh when I'm not feeling too happy, or whatever. Okay, so just say one prayer per person. Obviously you don't have to just pray once, you can pray as many times as you like, obviously. But yeah, this is just to help us remember that our lives are filled with really, really strong women that will teach us and be fill us with wisdom and teach us how to be kind and really be empowered people in our lives. So it's not just, women don't just empower women. Mums can also empower their sons, or a lady, like a lady teacher, can empower a boy in their class. It's not just the girls that will have this feeling, it's boys as well. Some boys are really more closer to their mums than some girls are. So I thought this would be a really nice activity for us to really think about those special ladies in our lives. And as it's International Women's Day on the 8th, and it's Mother's Day on the 14th, it's just a perfect time, I think. Yeah, so at the end of this video, there'll be a picture that you can either print out or recreate. Again, you can do it one for your mum and one for all the other ladies, or you can do them joined up. But I hope you have a really good time thinking about the ladies in your life and praying for them and asking God which ladies stand out. Because sometimes you've got a whole collection of ladies that you think, oh, all these ladies really give you good hugs. So then pray to God, ask him who he wants to put in your heart. Write that person down, because that person most probably would need prayer that you don't know why God is telling you to put that person down. So that's why I think pray to God if you're unsure. Okay, so I hope you have an amazing week. Good luck to all those children that are going back to school. You'll absolutely be phenomenal. You will smash it and you will have the great time being back at school. Okay, I'll see you soon and have a great week. Bye.